I got some more packages today. I'm gonna open them. I have to get some scissors. And don't ask me where they are. I always flip them around here, there, and everywhere because they're useful and then I use them.
Right behind me.
Got a little squash bug here.
Just check that window.
I do accidentally squash bugs on a daily basis because they go into the carpet to have a rest. And then I end up just squashing them. Or whatever. Or a step on them when I'm getting up in the morning. So, I got some more packages today. I've been over shopping. I did buy myself that fancy bracelet because it's like the last one and literally it's, okay. I literally cannot be bothered exchanging or returning items. So this was a good deal, 20 from 50, and it's a nice lightweight shirt. I don't know what it's made out of. What is it made out of? But I should check this one out. This one looks more promising than the last one. It looks a little tighter. But I did buy a size 14 because that's what size I have been, but I have a feeling I might have lost some weight. And I'm now more like a size 12. So, I'll just quickly try that on because it does look like a good fit. It'd be nice to get a shirt where I can wear it the interview, the photo shoot. I'm just going to go look at myself in the mirror because I have a feeling it's a good fit. I'll just be back in a second. I can say it's a lot tighter, but I can't say it's perfect, so it's literally too hot to wear, so I would have to change at the studio itself. I don't quite like the collar. I love it as a general shirt, but I don't know, for a photo shoot, I might be better off just wearing my normal shirts. These ones that I normally wear are a little, are actually a little more comfortable. But I don't know. Or I could wear that weird shirt. I think that weird shirt, though, would go well with some jeans. I don't know, I'm gonna keep this. This is good for packaging Christmas presents, which I bought $70 worth. And one of them was a toy. I thought it was, I actually thought it was a makeup set, and it was a makeup set that was a toy. So how dare toy people make a makeup set, you know, and not put like toy on the heading or something? It's like, this is a toy, because I overlooked it, and I accidentally bought a toy instead of a makeup set. So lucky I bought the extra moisturizer and whatever else. I bought the mask, the face mask, because that's what I'm going to give this person instead of the toy, instead of the makeup set. But I'll have to put the makeup set actually on eBay, and hopefully that will be picked up by someone. Christmas, that would be wonderful. So all this white paper, I like to keep the white paper because that's really good. What do you call it? It's really good gift wrap. So this has a little, I could technically give this, but this is actually for me. Auction off the toy. I bought this. I don't usually use this brand. It's a cheap brand. Do I still want it? It's a cheap brand. I'm not sure if it fits my skin very well. I only bought it because it was cheaper than other brands. It should be okay. I don't know. I have a feeling that I've used this brand at some other stage and I didn't like it or something. I always refer to it as a cheap brand that I never want to buy. I know I bought it because this is the same version of that brand. Nishio. I bet this is too light for me. I never actually used this brand at all. I literally don't like it, but I was sort of surfing for... Yeah, that does nothing for my complexion. Yeah, that's not the right color for me. Not even a... I mean, I could use it with my makeup, but literally... If you screw yourself, that's not technically the right color. Oh, it doesn't look so bad. Let me just rub it in a bit more. It looks too pink, it doesn't blend properly. Maybe I just use too much. It's okay. I could probably use it. I use cheap brands for interviews and things, and I'm playing with makeup at home. So it doesn't have to be perfect, but it does look a tiny bit too light. It looks okay. So, anyway, I gotta get this off my fingers. Oh, this is what I used today already, so. Yeah, no, I'll probably just play around with it. I really just need, the cheap makeup for, interviews and things. Literally, so. And it doesn't look too obscene. Just use a less amount, smaller amount or something. But it's, yeah, like I said, it's just for my interviews. And, you know, 15 is a lot less than 50, which is what I usually... I'm going to wash my hands. I should wash my hands. I don't know if I should handle... No. I'm going to wash my hands so I can handle these other products. I don't want to get makeup when I've just bought them. That is so like me. I think I did use Nadio brand ages and ages ago, and I swore off it though, because I just didn't like it that much. Like, I really didn't like it. I'm like, why, what's wrong with it? I'm like, I don't know, I just didn't like it compared to other brands, but, and yet I bought them because they were cheap, so I'll probably regret my choice. I probably should have paid $5 or $10 more for other brands. But if I don't like this brand, which I expect that I might not, I just won't buy it in the future. And I'm not sure about this. This seems a little... I don't know. It's just not my brand. I mean, I have a feeling, though, I did not like it for a reason, but I don't remember why I didn't like it. And I'm like... And when I was a teenager, I was like, oh, I'm never going to buy this brand again because I really hate it. And yet, here I am buying it. So I think possibly this is the only time I go off my normal brands. Like, I normally buy Revlon, Max Factor, sometimes L'Oreal, sometimes Maybelline, sometimes Astralis. And then I've got Clinique as my major product that I use. Clinique is just me in a makeup, but it's really expensive, and so I don't always splurge for it. Sometimes I cut corners and reach for other things, and that's where I buy other brands, because I'm not willing to buy Clinique more than once a year. Same with Swarovski. I don't buy Swarovski any more than once every 2 years. It's so expensive. So this is a nice shirt, but it's got white on it, so I won't be wearing that to the interview. But it's a high neck summer shirt, which is actually more like an autumn shirt, and I only bought it because I'm like, I like this shirt. I should actually try it on. It's a size large. I don't remember if I... Yeah, did I buy a size large shirt? Oh, and I did buy some Bonds. Because I'm sick of flimsy little underwears. So I buy Bonds for the... Made with Aussie's cotton, full coverage, soft leg. I buy Bonds because it's a really good brand, and... Literally... If you've got the money to splurge on Bonds, it beats, like, Lily Love. It's, like, what I usually wear when I'm buying cheapy things. Lily Love, I mean, it's comfortable, but when it starts to fray and tatter and stuff after a while, they become flimsy. Whereas these full coverage ones, they're just, like, a lot better. So I bought a few Bonds, thankfully. Because I'm chucking out heaps of underwear and everything right now. And I did have two supportive crop tops because they're only $10, but I reduced it to one. I've got like 4 or 5 crop tops that I'm still wearing out. So I just said, I'll just buy the one. Oh, but they didn't do my little bride thing. they didn't give me the one with the straps. I better get that sometime. It's probably coming. It's probably on its way because I really need that one for my shirts. And I'm wearing a particular shirt. These are just for casual shirts. They're not for. Yeah, but I have a feeling I really hate Nadio. Like, I don't buy Nadio brands. I probably should have splurged, and I wanted to buy a big Chemist Warehouse order, but because I've been spending so much on Christmas and birthdays recently, I'm like, oh, I can be bothered buying Chemist Warehouse, so I'm literally, like, avoiding to buy stuff from Chemist Warehouse. Otherwise, I would have bought myself a Revlon gift, Christmas gift set. It's like a little bag with, like, 3 lipsticks. A lip liner and something else. I don't know what the other thing is, but I was like, oh, it's so cute, it's only like $20. But I didn't end up buying that because I didn't make that Chemist Warehouse order. Cause I'm like, I'm way over my head in expenditures right now. Like I spent so much on birthdays. I spent so much on Christmas. And then I spent a few hundred dollars for myself. And of course I spent a few hundred dollars for storage and other things that I need to pay. And then I'm like, oh, and to buy another $100-something worth of stuff? I don't think so. Yeah, I regret buying Nadio anything because I'm like, I'm pretty sure I hate that brand. I'm not in love with it, but I'll see how it goes. I mean, if I really hate it, I'll just say to a relative, look, I've got some Nadio product, I just don't like it. Do you want to have it? Do you want to have it from your makeup box? And she'll be like, yeah. Because other people aren't as picky as me, and then I'll be like, scold, no matter what, don't go off your brands. You know your brands, just don't go off them. So, I got another welcome letter from the government. Exactly. There must be some voting thing going on because I'm getting voting letters for information on your sector. So I'm gonna try this on now. It should fit. And it's not really for, I just bought it because I like the shirt. I bought it when I was like in my 20s. And I was like, I've worn that shirt before. And it goes really well with jeans, and I'm yet to wear my jeans and this and that. I'm so glad I have my bracelet back. It's a comfort thing to wear bracelets. Saying that, I bought a new one today. A Swarovski bracelet. With all my shirts, I have to keep in mind that I could use... Wow, this is a really tight size large. Ooh, it's like really tight. I won't be able to wear this until I've trimmed up my waistline. It's too tight. I thought a size large would be give me some room. I wouldn't wear this to the photo shoot because literally it's got too much weight on. And I wouldn't wear it until autumn anyway because literally it's not as beautiful as you think. I've got a relative hanging around, so I'm just going to try to get this up in there, but it's just a bit too tight, it's more like a size 12, I'm a size 14. Unfortunately, that one doesn't fit that well. That's okay, I'll wear it later. It's an autumn shirt anyways, but literally nothing beats what I already have, so what a bum time for buying stuff. Literally. And my waistline is so big. I think I might end up just wearing this shirt and be like, screw it. This white is more like different colors. I think I'll just wear like this shirt at the photo shoot. And be like, I don't care what people think of me. literally, like, I'm not, except for the brown one, but I'm not really into my waistline right now, so I don't really want tight, tight clothes, so I might wear the blue bamboo one. I would have to get changed there because it's a long sleeve shirt, but it's going to be the dead of summer, but literally, I think that one might look okay if I tuck the shirt into the pants or something. But I don't know, I mean, I don't have a very good physical body right now, I'm like, school's me. Yeah, I have a feeling I don't really like this brand. It's like, I could have given away his Christmas present, and I'm like, no way, this is my cheap brand, so I'll try and use it, but I'll try and use it. I mean, it does look okay. You just put on a pretty light coverage, and then, yeah. So it should be okay. It's really just for home use anyways. For outdoor use, I use other brands. It's really just for interviews. Like, when I've got to put on makeup for interviews, I literally just put it on and wipe it off. So that's all it's for. And this will last like 6 months, maybe 3 months. Oh, I don't know.